Our next talk is from Robert Mayinge. From Kenya. Representing the University of New Mexico.
We are living proof that when human beings have the courage and the commitment to transform a dream into reality, there is nothing that can stop them. These are the words of Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, ruler of Dubai, speaking on the transformation of his city. My name is Robert Mayinge, a passionate architect from Nairobi, Kenya. And I am here to tickle your brain on how I believe architecture and innovative design can empower Africa to change the world's perception or misperception of our beautiful continent. And I will do this with the MISS, an MISS that I will use to communicate my message. Mindset. Paint a picture with me. Imagine a dry grass thatch roof seated on rusticated mud walls. At the front is a small opening with a skin mat that welcomes you into a dark, dingy house that has neither running water nor electricity. Now imagine this house in a cluster of five, forming a neighborhood seated on a dry, barren land. Be honest with me. Which continent are you on? Which continent are you on? Africa. Therein, ladies and gentlemen, lies the problem. Did you know that 7 of the 13 fastest growing economies are in Africa? This is according to a Business Insider report, 2015. Nairobi, my home city, ranked number 10 globally according to the City Momentum Index. JLL report 2017. And so why is this news to you? Mindset. Africa is changing at a pace faster than the world is able to absorb. And it is up to us, Africans, to tell that story and to tell the world. And how do I propose we do this? Innovation. I work with a firm known as Aspera Design. And we believe in the mantra that we can change the world's perception through architecture and the buildings and the ever-forming landscape of our beautiful continent. And you will ask, so what does innovation and buildings and design have to do with anything? Statement. Throughout the history of the world, nations, cities, and companies have made statements using architecture and the buildings that they put up. Be it the Sydney Opera House in Australia, or the Burj Khalifa in Dubai, be it even the One World Trade Center right here in the USA, New York. A statement is made. In Australia, they say, we are the capital of performing arts and opera in the world. In Dubai, they say, come, do business with us. And here in New York, they say, we stand tall, we stand proud. And so Africa should and very well will make its statement. The statement needs to be made. And why does it need to be made? Success. Success begets success. And if we as Africa put forth to the world a statement that we are growing through architecture and our forming landscape, the world shall respond. The world and the business, leaders, nations, cities shall respond to Africa and bring business back home. Ladies and gentlemen, we as Africans need to make this statement. The statement that Africa is no longer a place for aid by the benevolent and the gracious, nor is it a place to be ignored by the apathetic. Instead, it is a place for business, for collaboration, for partnership by every nation, city, and company that is looking to success. And that, my friends, is why we're here. Fellow Africans, join me in telling the world, don't you miss it.